So, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. So, my name is Sebastian, and I'm currently a postdoctor in Sun Yat-sen University in Guangzhou in China. And today I will present you a project that has been developed since more than 2 years and a half with several collaborators, an AIR package called Animal Network Toolkit, or ANT. So first of all, I would like to thank all my collaborators to work with me. And secondly, I wanted to tell you that we have published a few weeks ago a preprint on BioArchive. So if you want to know more about this package at the end of this presentation, you can download it freely. So ANT is a free open source AIR package. It is 48 networks metrics, 197 functions, 19,168 line of code, coded in CPP, partially for optimal computational speed. It handles multiple data collection protocols, multi-permutation approaches, and the goal of ANT is to provide a reliable social network analysis with a permuted statistical test. It's also to create a tool that can be used in different fields of animal research. And it's a multi-collaborative project, and we hope it will evolve with time. So if you're interested to participating in the development of ANT, you are welcome. So ANT started with my PhD research, in which I study how individuals' attributes affect individual position in the group, their role, and their interactional patterns, which finally participate to the emergence of a complex, dynamical, multi-layer, polyadic system with intrinsic adaptive properties. In other words, a society. And in order to study such system, I base my work on the conceptual framework of Robert Hines, who described a society as a multi-level system. And this conceptual framework can be synthesized by the following scheme, with the first level, what I call micro-level, are the individuals that build a society. So they are characterized by their individual attributes, such as age and sex, that may affect their agonistic, tolerance, and affiliative behaviors, among others. In the next level, those behaviors allow individuals to create affiliative, coalitional, and agonistic relationships. Those relationships build the final level, the hierarchical and affiliative structure, among others. And together, all these levels build a social structure or society. And if we do now a parallel between the social network analysis tools and those different levels, we can see how these new analytical techniques can highlight new phenomena in animal societies. So for example, for the first level, by using node metrics, we can highlight the individual position and role within the network. Secondly, by the use of dyadic metrics, we can study phenomena such as homophily, triadic closure, preferential attachment that allow us to highlight interactional patterns. And finally, by the use of global metrics, degree distribution, deletion simulation, or network simulation, we can highlight network or group structure and properties. So during my PhD, I studied Macaca sylvanus, and I managed to highlight several points, such as, for example, the fact that females are more active, more central, and contribute in a broader way to the cohesion of the network, such as juveniles. I also highlight the fact that allogrooming network is structured around homophily by sex, heterophily by age, triadic closure, and degree by associativity by degree. And finally, through deletion simulation, by deleting the most centric individual with the higher degree, such as female and juveniles, I managed to highlight the fact that this network is more sensitive to target deletions than random deletion. However, unlike scale-free network, the network doesn't disrupt even by deleting 20% of the most centric individuals. This shows us that the most centric individuals are very important for network cohesion, but they are not indispensable. So the idea of ANT was to bring this kind of multi-level network approach, and it became more than that. And ANT is structured according to analytical protocols, and we divided this type according to the data types that the user may use, according to Croft and collaborators' paper in 2011. So we separate them according to individual association or individual direct interactions. So let's start by individual association. which are usually used in behavioral ecology to assess preferential partners according to individual association in specific location. And due to the randomness of this type of data, we need to run data stream permutation approach on the raw data. And currently, Hunt allow to handle focal sampling and group follow. Once you have input your data, you can then realize data stream permutation according to several indices of associations. You can compute network metric on those permuted data to finally run permuted statistical tests. So for that data of direct interaction, such as grooming in primates, you can first, like in data stream permutation, study node position, but you will do it by computing first node metrics and then realizing node label permutation to finally do permuted statistical tests. You can also, like in data stream permutation, study interactional patterns, but you will first do link and or label permutation to compute the associativity, for example, the dyadic metric, and run permuted statistical tests. And finally, you can study overall network structure by doing link permutation first. You can use matricial regression or matricial correlation, deletion simulation, or compute global networks metrics and then run your statistical permutation test. And today, due to time limitation, I will show you how we can do these three aspects in Hunt. And to do that, I will use a part of my PhD dataset, and I will redo part of the analysis I do for these two papers. So let's start. And Hunt work with two types of objects. The first one is a matrix, so for individual interaction. And the second type of object is a data frame that store individuals' characteristics, such as age, sex, etc. We can compute node metrics by the function met, and here we will compute the degree of individual, the number of partners. You do that by inputting the matrix and the data frame, and here you are saying that the ID of individual is the column 1. So once you have this, you have a new column with the degree of your individuals. You can now do permutation with the class function perm here in network and node labels. To do that, you input your data frame, and then you put the labels you want to permute. Here we will permute individual attributes, age, sex, match line, and David score, the hierarchical rank of individuals. And finally, the last argument in this function is the number of permutation you want. Here we will do 10,000 permutation, and as you will see, thanks to CPP code, this type of permutation go very fast. So once you obtain this permuted object with all your 10,000 permutation, you can do permuted statistical tests. And to do that, here we will assess if degree of individual are different according to their characteristic. So here we will do a linear model in which we will see if degree is different, significantly different, according to their attributes. To do that, you input your permuted object, and then you use your formula. As you will see, here it is slower than previously, because currently in Hunt, statistics are not yet coded in CPP. We hope to do that in future, but we will need some time to do it. And what he's currently doing, he's doing 10,000 times the model you have to do, but doing it on the permuted data. And it is extracting the estimate of all this model to create a posterior distribution in order to compare it with the real estimates of your real data set, who is just printed here. So once it is over, you obtain an object with the posterior distribution of your specific statistic. And to obtain a permuted p-value and other statistics, you have to use the function Hunt in the package Hunt. So this will allow you to obtain a data frame with the permuted p-values, the left side, right side, the lower and upper confidence interval, and the mean of your posterior distribution, and the usual result of a linear model in R. You will also obtain a graphical with the posterior distribution and your real estimates. And here, like in the paper of 2016, you can see that we have difference in degree according to sex and age only. The other ones are not significant. And so let's do now some associativity tests. So we will do first node link permutation on your data. And to do that, you input your matrix and the number of permutation. Here is a little slow because it is not yet in CPP. So once you obtain this, you just have to compute the associativity of your network according to the attribute you want to test. Here we will do associativity by sex. So to do that, you again input the permuted object and the attribute you want to test. So here basically is computing the associativity on all your permuted data, and you will again obtain a posterior distribution of those associativity value in your data. And you will compare with the function ANT to the real one to obtain again the p-value, the confidence interval, and the mean of your posterior distribution. Now let's do some quickly data deletion simulation. And to do that, we use the function tstatDeletion, in which you input your matrix and the attribute. And as you can see, we obtain here in white target deletion by degree, and here random deletion. And as in my paper in 2014, here for the diameter, the global field efficiency, and the density of the network, you can see that they are more sensitive to target deletion than for random deletion. So voilà. We also have a future project for this package, and such as also lectures to go deeper in the possibility of HANTS. And if you have any suggestion, you are of course welcome to contribute with us. Thank you for your attention. If you want more information, we have an official website of HANTS. This is my personal webpage. And if you want to contact me to ask any question or collaborate, you can contact me on this email address. And you can also download the preprint, of course, as I told you in the beginning. Thank you very much.